Good morning from Portsmouth and Southsea. The orange high-vis is on. I'm about to meet my contact. Over there, you can see there's some people up on the bridge already. There's something called the Landport Viaduct, which is what connects Portsmouth and Southsea station down to the extension that they built down at Portsmouth Harbour. And Network Rail are in at the moment. There's a blockade. They've got the line closed off. They're doing some essential maintenance. Let's find out what.
Here's a quick map just to show that we're at Portsmouth. Portsmouth has two platforms, two of them terminate here, while two of them are used for services that carry on down to Portsmouth Harbour. It's just the one side of the station that's been closed off whilst this work takes place.
So once again, I've been assigned the blue hat. We all know what that means. That means I'm in the company of the white hats. By the way, that's Mark.
Nice to meet you.
And Chris is here. And that's Harry.
Hello.
At Portsmouth and Southsea Station, the tracks for the high-level platforms are above my head. Over there, you've got the original low-level platforms, platforms 3 and 4, which were here first, and then later, when the line was extended down to the harbour, they put in these two platforms above us.
Wow.
So up the steps, onto the platforms, platforms 1 and 2, with still the old Network Southeast red colouring in places, which I love, and it's a hybrid activity.
The Network Rail team are here specifically to replace what are known as wheel timbers. They're used in places and constructions like this bridge where it's made of a metal frame and regular sleepers can't be used. The rails sit on long wooden baulks which lay across the frame and are kept the right distance apart with cross braces.
Right, so just to let you know, so basically what you can see just beside us is a redundant wheel timber that we've removed from the track. As you can see stated on here, it says number 24, which means it was 24 left. Just on the track there is where our new wheel timber has been installed. And it's basically what it is, it's where the life expiry has come to its end. So you're looking at around, these wheel timbers tend to last around 10 years at a time. It is then determined when we actually remove the wheel timber.
Why can't you use regular sleepers in an environment like this?
It depends on the structure itself, the weight of the structure, whether it's a ballasted structure. So as you can see, it is a fixed structure, which means you can't put ballasted tracks, so it can't be sleepers. It's got to be wheel timbers. It gives the officer stronger depth and a better security of the wheel timber itself and the for the life expiry. As it stands, the type of material we use for the wheel timbers are wood. So you've got two different types. You've got your softwood and your hardwood. It all depends on the tannalisation of the wheel timber itself. However, we have recently started installing wheel timbers in FFU, which is basically a fibreglass material, and it offers a longer life expectancy of 50 years at the moment, and it could go up to 70 years depending on product approval.
Chris, what is this?
That's an RRV, that's a road rail vehicle.
Just checking you knew.
I know some things.
So what happens? The gang get down onto the track, they sort of nuts and bolts and stuff, then the RRV does the actual heavy lifting.
That's right, yeah, they'll basically get the wheel timber out. RRV comes in.
How do they get the timbers out of the station? I mean, you put them onto the platform.
So wait, RRV, you pick it up and you'll take it out. It gets chopped up into small pieces.
So it's going to get chopped up here?
The bridge here is from, did you say 1870? It's nice, but 1870. He's just showing me pictures. Some of the steel corrodes, because one, it's right near the water, the sea, so the air is a little bit more salty. But here's an amazing thing. In the winter, when they ice the platforms, they put down the salt, like the gritting salt, to de-ice the platforms. Some of that then falls down through onto the tracks and onto the steel structure below. And that also adds to the wear and tear of the structure. So there's a lot of works going on here to patch up the viaduct.
The work you can see going on behind me here is to strengthen the remaining spans of Landport Viaduct, carrying on from the work we did last year. The reason it's got that big tent over it is they're going to paint it as well to make it look all nice, and you can't just paint it in the open air because it's the middle of winter and the paint won't be in spec and it won't finish itself properly.
I've just seen a poster over there, South West Trains over here, notification of the line closure that they're doing between Guildford and Petersfield in February. And it's always just worth highlighting, pointing out that if Network Rail don't do this, if we don't do these things, then what the railway, Harry, you're going to pick on Harry, the railway would just got like slide into like disuse, wouldn't it, right? And trains, what would happen if Network Rail didn't patch up the railway.
So certainly with here, the importance of us doing the work now is to make sure that when trains can continue running at line speed over the bridge, without strengthening the columns and doing the essential work we're doing now, the trains will go slower, your journeys will be slower, there'll be more delays and kind of more frequent overnight emergency works, which will cause more delays and disruption to your journeys.
We've just had our documentation checked and sign off from the controller of site safety. There's a COSS, a COSS, on every Network Rail site in our briefing, which means I think we can go for a little track walk. Mark, what's this down here?
It is our brand new wheel timber that we'll be installing on the up road. So if you actually look just at the end here, you'll see it's stated, stamped with everything that is required. So it tells you that basically it's for Landport Viaduct, it's 1100, which basically determines it's the up road, and that it's a 21 left, and at this end is the London end. So basically you will know that this timber will have to be spun in order to be placed London end, that end.
Oh look, original station, 1980 station. Original station, 1980 station. Welcome to Portsmouth. Just casually walking down onto the tracks at Portsmouth. So we walked off the end of the platform just to come back and walk back down, because that's just the safest way of getting down to track level rather than climbing down. We're now coming back into the station and approaching the point of the works.
What they are currently doing is pinning the actual rails of the wheel timber that we've renewed. The reason why they're doing that is all in order to make sure that the track is sitting at the correct gauge for the track and section that it's working on.
Did he say the gauge was 1432?
What?
Yeah, that's probably metric, I imagine.
Okay.
The 4 foot three. Hang on,
so 4 foot 8 3/4.
4 foot 8 1/2.
4 foot 8 1/2, sorry.
Yeah.
It's 1432. What? Are we doing the metric?
Hey Siri, 4 foot 8 1/2 inches in millimeters. He's 1.435. We should start a new trend, Chris. For years, everyone talks about Brunel gauge, Stevenson gauge, 4 foot 8 1/2. From now on, I'm just going to call it 1435. So there we go, that is wheel timber replacement taking place on the Landport Viaduct here at Portsmouth and Southsea. Yet more essential maintenance by Network Rail and the great work that they do to keep our railway safe and running and in tip-top condition. Thanks for having me again. I'll leave you with a few generic shots of maintenance and work taking place.